Greetings, white positive people. Just got one thing to say here, real quick. Start off.
I don't practice
Santeria. No crystal ball. All I have is the going free lens of seeing things. White, anti-white. White positive, anti-white. That's it. Right? Little song to bring y'all into Southern Cal here. Coming into San Bernardino. Stop off in Barstow. I got a little bit of a story.
Whatever they were speaking, Kenyan,
I think they might speak Swahili in Kenya. But my guess is it was an African language. So these were just straight up real. And again, this is kind of common these days too. Bona fide, fresh, straight from the continent of Africa. Straight from a lot of continents, but we get a lot of them from that continent. The dark continent. For a reason. And so I go in there and they're speaking their language and they're always kind of a little bit rough around the edges, you know. Some of them don't seem to quite have manners. Or maybe it's just because they don't speak our language. But they just seem a little rough to me, some of them. And they come, you know, they're coming in here, they're just taken, right? Taking advantage of everything here. And taking jobs, taking everything, luxuries that we created. And there was a few of them in there, enough to kind of make, it was noticeable. Especially when they're speaking a different language, it's kind of like, you know, it's a little awkward always. So you know what this Blue Ninja did? And this was just off the cuff. Just a common thing here, just no big deal, totally unplanned. But I go in there, I see these dark non-whites speaking African language in the store. I go into the restroom, I see some dark non-whites in there speaking their African language. So I'm kind of like, yeah, you know, this Blue Ninja's had enough of this. This White Apostle's had enough of this. So time to do a little Blue Ninja / White Apostle combo. So I'm just like, yeah, you know what? I'm going to say something here. Sometimes it just strikes me. Just randomly when in certain situations that are really bad. Just don't feel like taking it. We can always speak out about stuff. That's one thing we can always do. So I said, well, okay. I can't really do anything about them being here right now, even though I don't like it. But I can speak out about what's going on. I didn't do anything crazy like yell in the store or anything, so don't worry. Blue Ninja's not going that overboard yet. Yet, but will if necessary, to believe that. We'll do anything necessary to save the people. Bar none, no ifs, ands, or buts, period. So I'm like in the restroom seeing these darks speaking their language, out in the store speaking their language. And I'm just like, man, I'm just not in the mood for this right now. I can't get away from it. So I look and I say, you know what? I think I feel like saying something here. I look over, the cashier is white. A white young lady. There was a white gentleman. Trucker. Standing, waiting for something. Kind of near the counter. So I said, okay. Because they were white, because the cashier was white, I decided, okay, I'm going to say something. I wanted to say something to a white person. Because obviously everyone notices this stuff. When you got darks taking over stores, rampaging through and speaking their language and all that, being loud and rambunctious, you know, it's obvious. It makes a mark. It's uncomfortable. So I said, okay, I'm gonna say something to this cashier. So I go up to the cashier, I'm buying my stuff. And I say to her, do you notice all the multiracialism now? That's what I said. I said, you notice all the multiracialism now? You know, all the different races we have living here. And she was kind of like, yeah. You know, you get those shell-shocked looks, and I just didn't care. Like, yeah. Well, I said, you know, that's just erasing white people. That's all that's doing. That's the only purpose of it. It's just erasing white people. And she kind of misunderstood. She was like, what's wrong with white people? And I was like, nothing. That's the point. I'm trying to defend white people. So, I mean, that was good. But she had some white positivity there. But she kind of misunderstood what I was saying. She was like, oh, what's wrong with white people? I was like, no, no, nothing. That's my point. I'm defending white people. I'm saying white people are being erased by all this multiracialism, and that's a bad thing. So, you know, I'm just trying to spread awareness. And she was like, oh, okay, I'm sorry. And it was all good. And I was like, I'm with you, sister. I love white people. I'm white. I'm just trying to point it out. We're down. We're decreasing in number because of this stuff, this multiracialism. I want to bring this back up. So, I got a little revved up too because I was low on blood sugar and now I got some food in me. So I apologize if the volume's a little high right now, folks. But that's what happens, you know. Sometimes you don't eat for a while in the truck, and then you know you get a chance to get some food, and you get a spike. It's the ups and downs. But so I just preached it to her, and I was nice and bold and plenty, you know, good volume. The white guy behind could definitely hear. Kind of gave him a nod on the way out. So just preached to two white people right there. And I was just like, right on, sister, she got it, she agreed. And I was just like, you know, just keep spreading it yourself. I said, I'm just trying to spread the awareness. All this multiracialism is erasing us whites. We gotta fight against it. Just spread the word, spread the word. And that was that. And then I go out, and from there I went into a McDonald's. And I go into the McDonald's and there's two white dudes there. Lo and behold, in Barstow, California, that's kind of rare. SoCal folks, donning armor, Mrs. Jess Horst. SoCal folks, you all will know, of course, most of us know. Whites are pretty rare in Cali, especially SoCal. In general. So I'm just like, wow, what a treat. I'm going to this McDonald's, two white dudes, strong looking, just young, middle-aged, peak. Well, one of them was a strong, you know, older, not older, young, middle-aged, just strong looking, prime white dude, beard on, rugged, blue eyes just like me. I was like, oh, that's cool. Other guy was a little bit older, the other white guy. Still looking like some pretty solid white dudes in there. So it's like, oh, this is beautiful, you know? I think I might just keep this momentum going right now and just say something to these guys too. Again, just totally off the cuff, just ain't no thing. You know, just whatever, just you know. I just said, hey, notice all the multiracialism now, all the different races? And he's like, yeah. And I was like, you know, that's just erasing white people. It's just here for white erasure. That's the purpose. And these two dudes totally agreed. There was no argument. You know, it is easier than ever, everybody, to get this message to people. At the gas station, at the store, wherever you just sit. To the next person in line standing next to you, white person, you can just casually say these things, especially if you got an example of multiracialism or white erasure or anti-whiteism right there. You can be like, ooh, look, that's anti-white, or you know, you notice the multiracialism, something like that. But these are just easy, so I'm just like, yeah, you guys notice the multiracialism? Yeah, that's just white erasure, it's just erasing us white people. They totally agreed. They're just like, yeah, right. And one guy said, yep. He said, he said he had a friend or a family member that has been saying that for years. He's like, I got a friend that's been saying that for the past 2-3 years, that all this multiracial stuff is just erasing white people. Whites are going down in number. So it was just total agreement, like, yeah, yep, absolutely right. White erasure is erasing whites, yep. No argument, nobody can argue with this stuff now. Easier than ever to get this message across to white people, folks. And just said a couple more things to him that, you know, just like, hey, you know, we gotta wake up. We white people gotta wake up. We gotta smell the coffee, smell the white erasure. We gotta understand that all this kumbaya, multiculturalism nonsense, that's multiracialism. It's just here to erase us whites. There is no, it's not about all of us living together or anything like that. It's about erasing us out of existence, biological white erasure, race mixing, and all that stuff. They were just like, yeah, total agreement from the start. No argumentation whatsoever. And I just said, yeah, we gotta wake up, we gotta spread the word, you know, being erased. Spread the word. Multiracialism is white erasure. I like that phrase. I think I'm gonna use that soon. Post that places. So watch out for that. I think that's gonna be my next evangelical phrase. Multiracialism is erasing white people. What do y'all think? Multiracialism, I wanna make a big sign. Multiracialism is erasing white people. Or multiracialism is white erasure. I think that's gonna get it across. So I'm just saying to these guys, you know, we gotta spread the awareness. And they were just like, yeah, man, you're right, right, yeah. And then they were just like, yep, absolutely. And one guy said, and they were both super cool, man. And the one older guy said, yeah, we're always made to look like the bad guy, you know. And I said, yep. I said, that's their excuse to harm us and erase us. They need an excuse. They need to try to justify it. They need, you know, they can't just come right out. I mean, the reason is, I said, is because they hate white people. They just hate white people. They're just against white people. They just want us gone. They can't come out and say that, so they come up with these excuses. Whites are bad for this, that, or the other reason. Therefore, it's okay to harm them, it's okay to erase them, etc., etc. He was like, yep. Yeah. And I just said, for example, that word racist, that's an anti-white slur. It's nothing but a derogatory term against white people. And he was just like, yep, you got that right. He's like, no shit, man, you are so right. So right. Right from the get-go, instantly, he was like, yep. Bingo. I said, yep, you got it. I said, it's only used against whites. He was like, yep, you're right. Derogatory term against whites, that's all it is. He's like, yep, you're totally right. I said, so what you do if you ever hear it, you just call it an anti-white slur. Anybody ever calls you racist, says the word racist or racism to you, you just say, that's an anti-white slur. He was like, yeah, right on, man. He was just like, no shit, that is, yes, cool. He loved it. And then he was out of there. And he just said, good luck, man. And I was like, thanks, you too. You know, we're in it together. But they loved it. On board. Just super casual. No big deal. just reached three or four white people there at the truck stop and dumped. Just, that was just a cash, very cash thing. Just, this blue ninja is not having it anymore. You all, not having it anymore. We're not having it anymore, right? Anti-whiteism, we're not having it anymore. Anti-whites, not having it. White erasure, harm toward our people, we're not having it anymore. We're not having one single bit of it anymore. If I feel the urge to start preaching the word of white well-being to save our people at a truck stop, so be it. That's what I'm going to do. I just reached a bare minimum of four white people here today. Tonight. So that's how easy and simple it is, folks, as we know. So we are all not taking it anymore. That's all I got for now. Make it just a quickie. Quick one. And I'm going to get into LA pretty soon. And pray that there's not too much traffic. And then I'm going to shut down. Then I'm going to be heading up to Bay Area tomorrow. It's another day in the life of the working man, trucker, blue ninja. Serving white well-being alongside all of you all. Till tomorrow morn. Tomorrow or next time. I love y'all. God bless each and every one of you. Stay white positive. Let's keep going. Free. Let's take it out here with see what's playing. Ace of Base. Who remembers Ace of Base? Never gonna say I'm sorry. To white folks. Never gonna say sorry to us, our fellow whites. Western kind. Long live. Long live Western kind. Long live our kind and our people, everybody. Fired up. Damn. Skippy right. Get that fire going, folks. When we see the battle, no one rises to the battle better than whites. We just have to see it. And I feel it that whites are seeing it now. We're recognizing, holy guacamole, we're being erased. Wait a minute. Our backs are against the wall. We're on the run. We're being attacked. Time to rise up once again to start a new epoch of white prosperity. So Ace of Base doesn't quite seem to be fitting here. I listened to this stuff back in the 90s when I was younger. You know, 90s pop, Swedish, white people, beautiful white ladies singing this song, these songs. White girls, women from back in those days. The generation that I was a part of too. A lot of white girls probably listened to that stuff. This was popular in the 90s. A lot of us will remember. Those seem like the good old days, doesn't it? Who'd have thought the 90s, the good old days, 20, 30 years ago already. Unbelievable. But popular music, good music. White music, of course. Swedish pop. It's hard to beat it. Definitely unique and very good stuff. I love this stuff. I still do. Just really got a nice sound to it. The melody is so creative. Beautiful, white, creative spirit behind this music here. Western biosphere. The magic of the Western biosphere at work. one of many areas. So here's a billboard, your best shot against the flu. And it's all non-whites. It's a family of all blacks. All five blacks on that billboard. Get a flu shot. Sorry about this song. Not the best. But get a flu shot. So they, you know, what do they want? Flu shot or COVID shot? These anti-white powers that be, they can't seem to make up their health experts. Anti-whites, they can't seem to make up their mind. They want a flu shot. They want a COVID shot. They want both. But you know they want that COVID shot. And I saw something that said that essential workers are going to be at the front of the line for getting the vaccine. I guess that might mean me as a truck driver. Trucker. As a trucker. You know, all the healthcare workers, medical people, you know, essential, the truckers like me, drivers, deemed essential, and then some others as well, but, you know, the essentials, they're going to try to put me at the front of the line? No way, Jose, no how. Is this Blue Ninja going to take a vaccine? Y'all tell me the answer to that question. No way on God's green heaven or earth. Is that going to happen? Side note, let's take it out here. Speaking of pop, this is a good one. Let's just take it out with something smooth here. Set adrift on white memory bliss. White days, everybody. We had white country.